Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner. I'm available for code reviews and on-site training. Now, in this episode, we have a couple of new preprocessor things that we need to discuss that came in C23 and will probably be available to us in C++. And I've hinted at one of them, well, directly mentioned one of them before. The other one is not one that I've mentioned yet. Now, as you can see here, the first one that I'm going to discuss is hash or pound embed, depending on where you come from. And I have up here a link to John Heed Manid's blog on embed. Now, this has been something that John Heed has been working on for 5 years. This has been a long time coming. And for those of us who have done things with embedded scripting or large embedded things of any sort, I mean, embedding resources in your C or C++ projects tends to be rather painful. And embed is going to solve that problem by giving us a clean cross-platform way of doing that. And I'm going to demonstrate this in a very simple way. But before I do that, I do want to remind you to check out the description of this video and make sure you provide any episode ideas that you think would be interesting. I am slowly working my way through this. As you can see, I currently have 178 open ideas. So it is very important that you come in and actually vote on the things that you find interesting. I will not be going in a strict order here because I can't necessarily. Some things take a lot of research and some things simply don't have compiler support yet. And I do wait until there is some form of compiler support before I actually demo a feature. And also, of course, check out links to my books, Patreon, t-shirts, you know, all the stuff that helps support this channel. So I have gotten a fair number of comments lately about the size of my fonts and stuff. This example does have a fair bit going on. I will try to make this all as readable as possible. This is a CMake-based project in Compiler Explorer. If you don't know what Compiler Explorer is, then I suggest you watch some more of the episodes of this channel, or watch some of Matt Godbolt's talks on Compiler Explorer. But this is compiler-explorer.com. It supports CMake projects. This is a relatively advanced feature of Compiler Explorer that does not get used very often. But this is a pretty simple project. It just has one file. At the moment, it's named file 2. That's because, well, I reused an earlier project. And we've got an input file. And this says, well, a whole lot of text. And in this code, I have a static constexpr char array. And I open it up, and this is where I'm going to put the data. And I have a preprocessor macro. And all this does is it takes this file and just smashes it in here. So if you can see down here, I have wow a printed. Let's make this bigger. So it says wow a down at the bottom. This is because I have used the feature of limiting how many bytes can actually be read. And this feature exists partially because you might do something like this, which I think would be completely valid. Although, yeah, I'm not sure what Compiler Explorer is going to do here. Oh, intriguing. So this exists currently as a compile time literal. It is reading 5 bytes from devrandom. A fascinating thing to do. Let's see if we can actually print this. Okay, yes, so I have read 5 random bytes from random. And they were embedded into this executable at compile time. We can see that it's just a single call to puts after setting up some stuff on the stack. Let's go ahead and put this back to our input.txt. Now, if I was actually trying to read from dev random, then that could have caused a problem because it would have read an infinite number of bytes if I had not put a limit on there. So I have this input.txt, and if I remove the limit, then I should see, well, a whole lot of text printed down here when it's done compiling and executing. And there you go. So this is designed to ease the pains with embedding resources into your C++ projects. Now, I know a lot of you are going to say that's useless, and a lot of you are going to say I've been waiting for this my entire life. So go ahead and leave a comment on which side of the fence you are on there. But those of you who think that it's useless, read the comments from people who say they've been waiting for this for a long time, and perhaps you'll get a better idea as to why it is not useless. Okay, so this brings us to the second thing that I want to demo. And again, this is not a very complicated feature, but it's the fact that we can actually give a warning directive in C++23 and in C23. And that's kind of cool. So you might do something like this and check to see if something is just outside of what you have been able to test on your project, for example, or warn if there's some non-ideal compile time situation, which I'm guessing any of us who have written cross-platform code in the past has dealt with this kind of scenario. So it's pretty straightforward. It's a new way to actually generate a compile time warning. And you can see it actually get generated here. So that's really all there is to say about this particular feature, just a standard way of doing this now across all compilers. So thank you for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. Be sure to subscribe. Hope you enjoyed this episode, and make sure to leave a comment.